specific scenarios, adding scenarios, and your coverage for your simulation is increasing. So I mentioned machine learning. Real key part of this, and a really critical part of why simulation is needed, that you're making changes to your training data sets, and the black box is being, the neural network, it's not completely well understood, the training data, how that affected the results of the changes to your machine learning algorithm. So you have to take a very comprehensive testing approach to this, and simulation is a very much a key part of this. So I want to start to set the basis for how big of a multi-dimensional problem this is. This is 3x3, but it's, you know, it's factors of n. This is a very large space of all the different variables that you have in play. And traditional simulation just can't handle this. You need to be able to take Monte Carlo-based simulation. Google calls this concept fuzzing, another thing from the CarCraft article. But you need to be able to take all the different variables in play. And you're not just testing for one specific scene, but you're testing for performance boundaries all around that. So changing various variables and seeing what the impact and results of that. And you can learn so much more about your system and test for regressions. Okay, so we're going to talk a little bit about our offering. I'm going to be showing a lot of different videos that you're going to see tonight. And those are all coming from our test runners. And that is our ability to run those millions of tests in a cycle. That's scalable, on-demand simulation priced by the simulation hour. Thus, our simulation as a service model gets away from the old style of enterprise licensing that you find with traditional simulators. Allows companies to get started earlier, stick their toe in the water before making a big, large commitment. Our scenario designer is our test development tool for building the tests that you're going to see, building both tests and training data collection exercises. You're going to see our test runner, which is used for analyzing the test results. And then we're providing scene and scenario packs. So far, Metamodo has taken a very lean startup approach. So what we have, these various tools are not generally available to the public yet. We've have various early engagement customers that we're working with of various flavors, OEM, Tier 1, Rideshare, various sensor companies. Sensor ecosystem is extremely important. And then also stack providers. And really mastering, making sure that these work and they're solving problems for all of these different types of customers. We've got those early engagements going on right now, and then we'll be making some announcements later this year for bringing the rest of this out to everybody else. So here is our first simulation. So here's a scalability example. The ability to run one test, interesting. It's taking that test and running it in many different ways. And to be able to identify those performance boundaries, finding key edge cases. I'm going to give some examples of this. So here we're giving examples of changing weather, time of day, road conditions. If you look, very detailed, these are small, but you can definitely see the different variations, and the results of the tests are very different. So here are some parameter examples of obviously environmental factors like road conditions, traffic, lane markings, but then going beyond that, also being able to change the hardware factors at various failures, introducing noise, dirt on sensors, bird poop, for example. Things that you would commonly find out in the environment and introducing those. And then you're not only just changing those external factors, you're also changing things like sensor settings, controller settings, physical properties using the simulation for optimization purposes. So here's an example of changing road conditions. So we're not only changing the physical properties on the road. You're going to see potholing, tar snakes. We're changing the lane markings, puddling. But we're also changing the material properties, and those have distinct effects on the various sensors. So sensors is what we're going to be talking about next. Here's a video that we did with Quanergy at CES that they had this running in their booth next to the Fisker. So that was, you know, but we still got a lot of looks for this, so that was good. This is showing their S3 LiDAR, their solid state LiDAR. They've got six of them on here. This is an example of, for them, creating a very specific sensor model. So we're supporting LiDAR, GPS, radar, IMU, camera at this time. You can set various, you can set the sensor settings according to spec sheets, but more importantly, you can create your own specific models that leverage the actual source code and the firmware that you can bring into the cloud and get more specific sensor modeling, which is extremely advantageous using LiDAR, basically ray tracing type services to simulate some of the beam activities. So here's another example that we did at CES with MetaWave. This was great. Probably many of you know the difficulties, the complexities of radar. Doing that's a very exhaustive simulation. It takes a very long time to do it very precisely. Most groups do simulation with object lists. MetaWave is taking a new beamforming approach with radar, very thin beams, making it much more LiDAR-like. Not only is it more advantageous to be able to model in simulation, but it's also proving to be a very superior technology in the aspect of putting 50 radars out on the road, the interference that causes, that's not really sustainable for autonomous systems. And accordingly, everybody's learning that, and a company like MetaWave is coming forward with this new radar approach, which we think is going to be very effective. What's great is that we've been able to model this and provide this new model of radar in our simulation in a straightforward fashion. So here's an example of ground truth. So not only using, we know everything in the virtual environment, and everything is labeled, everything is tagged. You could pull data sets out of the environment. I gave an example earlier for machine learning training purposes. You can use it for various algorithmic verifications. Everybody is using, you know, there's numerous labeling companies that are out there that exist. The need for this is very great. It's another great application of simulation. So now I'm getting into, we're going to introduce here for the first time, if we haven't showed this, you know, publicly to an audience yet. This is our test run. This is our cloud environment for running those tests. Red is, here's all of our different test suites. Red is that one or more tests failed. Green is that they all passed. Orange is that there were some type of stop condition. You can see the various test history for your different test suites. Give examples of that. So what introduces the concept in our world, test suites are made up of test vectors. Think of test vectors as highly parameterizable tests. And you can set various parameters and then run that test in different ways, very vectorized, you know, thus the word vector. So here's the next video. I'm going to give an example. So here we're going to do our first example. We're going to do this urban training test suite. The test suite, here's an example of the REST API and the REST integration. You can use our web UI. You can equally use it in your continuous integration environment, never opening the test interface. So here's an example of a single test vector. This suite is just a single test vector. You can have suites with many, many test vectors, but we're giving very simple examples here. And here's an example of us running it and showing then that the simulation is run. So here is our results analyzer. And here's an example. Here is that urban training, that urban training simulation. So fully dockable windows. Here we're breaking out the various sensor views. We have our log messaging on the right side, LiDAR controls up above. Hitting play on this, I'm going to walk through. We're showing the various variables in the scene. Now, imagine in time, one of the ways forward for us is that we want to provide in this tool even more visibility in the stack. So that's, in a future expansion of this. Everything is fully scrubbable. We can jump to various points along the graph. We can jump to various log messages. You can envision in time that this is going to be more tightly integrated with various debuggers and development tools that autonomous systems developers are using. Here's an example of our LiDAR view. We're changing the, we can change the history on it. We can also change the window centering. So I've set it now that it's only showing the LiDAR, the LiDAR in the future. So it's only showing the LiDAR in the past. You can move those windows around to view in the future and move back in the past. That's the advantage of the simulation. And here we're stopping for a pedestrian. That controller does a good job of obeying pedestrians moving around. So there's the first example. So we use this exercise. We grabbed training data. So let me give an example of this. So here's an extracted results file from this. Here's the various sensor views. You can envision that this was a folder of PNGs that you could use for various purposes. We've encoded this for presentation purposes. Here's another example. Here's the ground truth data for being able to pull out various data sets. Collecting all of the LiDAR point cloud data. Right, so here's another scenario. You probably saw that on the list. Here's a two trucks scenario operating in a range showing LiDAR, a scenario where we're going between two trucks, and you'll notice at the last minute the truck in the rear is going to merge at the end. We're showing different views. Here you're going to see another view behind the car. Good example of weather conditions. You can see good photorealistic scene. Very reminiscent of 280. So here's another example, us running the blind left turn. So in this test vector is parameterized with six